Good morning from Montrose Old and St Andrew's Church, and welcome to our short thought for the day. Everyone is under pressure. That's probably true most years, but it's even more true this year. That's understandable with inflation running so high and the stresses and strains of making ends meet impacting on how we're feeling, how we get on with others, even our outlook on life as a whole. It won't be unusual if the worries result in sharp words in the family or among friends. They are a knock-on, and we need to be alert for them. And where possible, make allowances and endeavour to maintain good relationships. We need one another more than ever. Sometimes when we're under pressure, we make greater demands on one another. Sometimes demands that we can't meet. The disciples were under extreme pressure after Jesus' death. Many of them were terrified that they would be next to be arrested, perhaps even put to death. Even the good news that was filtering out that Jesus was alive was hard to take in. Was it wishful thinking? Had the pressures become too much for folk that they were imagining things? Jesus appeared to his disciples on Easter Sunday evening, while the doors were locked to protect them from the authorities. It was a wonderful occasion and confirmed what the woman who'd met Jesus in the garden earlier had said. Jesus was alive. He had risen. They'd seen him with their own eyes. For whatever reason, Thomas hadn't been with the group and he wasn't convinced. He wanted to see for himself. He couldn't live his life on someone else's say-so. Unless I see the nail marks in his hands and put my finger where the nails were and put my hand in his side, I will not believe. But the following week, when Jesus met with the disciple group and Thomas was there and was invited to put his hands on the scars, he didn't. He didn't feel the need. He fell before Jesus and exclaimed, "My Lord and my God." He knew it was Jesus, alive and risen. He knew Jesus to be the Son of God, whom he believed him to be. The penny had dropped. His reluctance to believe dissipated, and faith came flooding in. I'm sure that his faith was even stronger than it had been, and his demands for cast iron proof evaporated. The fact that Jesus was there in front of him took away any need for him to touch Jesus' wounds. Jesus is more than happy to give us time and space for us to take in his message of love, for our faith to grow, for the penny to drop, for us to realise that he isn't a dead figure from history, but the risen Saviour who's still with us, as he promised. We can't touch his scars, but we don't need to. He comes to our hearts, to our spirits, confirming that he loves us and inviting us to share in his journey to tell and live out the good news of salvation. That doesn't remove us from the stresses and strains of everyday life, but it does provide us with a deeper, more profound reason to live and the assurance that Jesus loves us and will be with us always. Thanks for joining us. May the Lord bless you. Amen.